The sound of the band One Republic and its lead singer Ryan Tedder are familiar in hit songs like Counting Stars. But it's the songs where you don't hear Tedder's voice that have made him one of the most successful people in the music business. When the biggest stars in the world want a hit, they call Ryan Tedder. He takes their concept, then sits down with a guitar and a computer in a closet-sized room at his home and begins to compose the songs we all hear on the radio. I dropped by Tedder's place in Los Angeles, where he was putting the finishing touches on a new song for Stevie Wonder and Ariana Grande, and he insisted we stick around for a homemade steak lunch. Cheers.
Nothing.
Thanks for having me over.
Thanks for coming.
The rosemary and thyme is just nice.
Like, Ryan Tedder always is trying to get just the right flavor.
Cooking is probably my favorite thing to do other than music, because you're engaged.
Tedder is perpetually engaged as lead singer of his band One Republic. And as the in-demand producer behind some of the biggest hits of the last decade. He won a Grammy with Adele and another with Taylor Swift. He's put together hits for U2 and Beyonce.
Why is it that Taylor Swift, Adele, Beyonce, all these acts that are the biggest in the world, why do they call you? What is the Ryan Tedder thing?
It's because I smell so good.
It's just
Can
the smell.
Smell right now?
Yeah, I didn't want to say anything.
I think what I do, maybe that's specific to me, is I have a certain emotional currency in the lyrics and melodies that I do. So what I'm constantly chasing is like physical goosebumps at all times.
Still finishing the album.
For Tedder, inspiration can strike in some very tight spaces.
I think recording in the least suspecting places is oftentimes way more inspiring. Just your bedroom, an apartment, a hotel, you know, an airplane bathroom. I have all these voice memos on my phone where you can hear the, you know.
Well, if you look to your right, you can see Lake Michigan.
The road to becoming an international hit maker began in Oklahoma, where he learned to play music in a Pentecostal home.
Was there always music in the house?
There was always music in the house. My dad was a musician. He was a songwriter for a while, gospel music. So we always had a piano sitting around, and I started lessons when I was three. The music that was around when I was a kid was mostly gospel music or Christian music. Growing up, I was surrounded by cowboys and pickup trucks and football and like Friday Night Lights, and I was the guy that was like quietly listening to Peter Gabriel and like import CDs that I was getting from my uncle who lived in London.
It was the back cover of one of those discs that gave Tedder his first break.
At the back of every CD that you'd buy or DVD, there'd be a number. If you have issues or whatever, calls and complaints, I'd call the complaint hotline. Somebody would pick up eventually after like 100 calls. How can I help you? Oh, and I'd say, oh, I'm sorry, I was on the phone with HR, human resources, and I think they misconnected me.
Crafty.
And I would literally then work my way up. I'm sorry, because they always feel so bad.
Right.
And then they would connect me up to eventually I'm talking with the head of HR of Paramount Pictures from a dorm room in Tulsa. I got a call from DreamWorks one day. It was their Nashville office, and they had just opened a record label and a publishing company. And they're like, we want you to work for the publishing company of DreamWorks. Through a complaint hotline, I ended up in Nashville.
That's unbelievable. Yeah.
While writing for other artists and for TV and movies, Tedder never stopped thinking about his own music. Didn't think I'd turn around. In 2002, he reunited with an old high school buddy to form a band. In 2007, One Republic had its first big hit.
Is it Apologize that changed everything?
Apologize definitely helped. Timbaland took it, remixed it, and at the same time that Apologize was coming out under the One Republic's name, Bleeding Love was coming out under Leona Lewis's name, and I had a single on J-Lo, and I had a single on Natasha Bedingfield, and it kind of, When It Rains, It Pours, so it all happened at the same time.
The band's third album, Native, went platinum, spinning off hits like Counting Stars. And this week, the band's latest, Oh My My.
How are you describing this new album to fans?
You know, we have features from Peter Gabriel to Pharrell and Santa Gold. There's songs that anybody that loved Apologize or Good Life or Stop and Stare, that like the older stuff that we've done, they're gonna love it. But then we shift gears and we're gonna throw some people for sure. I'm constantly seeking out new sounds, new artists, new technology. Technology is a huge catalyst for new sounds.
The new music comes in the same year Tedder celebrates his 10th anniversary with wife Genevieve.
What are you doing?
The parents of two young boys met during their college years.
Back at college, could you have imagined? Did you see any of this coming?
I mean, there were plenty of times where I think both of us were like, what are we doing? What is going to happen, you know, and is this worth it? It was interesting to be with somebody when everything was sort of just this unknown and a dream, I guess. And then to see it come to fruition is pretty incredible.
A climb together to the top of the music business that just may have been meant to be.
It seems to me there was never a chance you were not going to be a musician in some form.
I think so. For me, it kind of became the self-evident path that I was supposed to be on.
Tedder has produced songs for just about every big name you can think of, but there is one man he's still dying to work with, Paul McCartney. Tedder told me he'd do anything McCartney wanted to do. Cover of a Mariah Carey Christmas song? Sure. Or, Tedder said, he and Paul could just grab a cup of coffee and Ryan then could say he'd collaborated with Sir Paul McCartney. To hear exactly how Ryan Tedder sits and puts together all these hits, check out our web extras at today.com/Sunday. The new One Republic album, Oh My My, is available now, and Ryan and the guys will perform live right here on Today this Wednesday. And next